Hello friends, in this video you'll learn about the structure, various properties and functions of vacuole. So vacuole is another membrane bound organelle which is present in all plants, fungal cells and some protist cells, animals and bacterial cells. It has a single membrane which is called tonoplast, and you can see in this picture, in these pictures, that all the cells contain vacuole, but like in animal cell there's a vacuole, quite a bigger one in case of plant cells, and fungal cells also have a vacuole, but there's a huge difference of size in all of them. In the animal cell, a vacuole is actually the same endosome or phagosome and exosomes formed during endocytosis and exocytosis. These are the same vesicles in the cell cytoplasm, and even the lysosomes are also the digestive vacuoles containing the digestive enzymes in eukaryotic cells. So this organelle basically has no specific any shape or size. Its structures varies according to the needs of the cell, and the function and significance of vacuole also varies greatly according to the type of the cell, having much greater prominence you can see in the cells of plants, as here the vacuole like occupies more than 50% of the space in the cell. And in the fungal cell also you can see that in the cytoplasm, vacuole is found to be the biggest among all other organelles. So it all depends upon the type of the cell and their function. Vacuole is basically filled with water containing some inorganic and organic molecules, including enzymes in solution. So we call this fluid inside as a cell sap. Now let's discuss the functions of vacuole. So there are numerous functions of vacuole which just seem to be an empty bag in the cytoplasm. So first is that vacuole present in the plant cell contains water, and due to osmosis this water diffuses in and out of the vacuole according to the cell's need. So it maintains a pressure and it maintains a balance of water, as well as since it allows the movement of salts also, so it maintains the pH balance of the cell. So, and because of this water present inside, the volume of water present inside the vacuole, it applies a turgor pressure, a hydrostatic pressure. You can see the water inside this vacuole, which applies a pressure on the cellular components, and all the components are drawn towards the cell membrane. And it also applies a turgor pressure, which is the force applied by the cell that pushes the plasma membrane, by the cell vacuole rather, that pushes the plasma membrane against the cell wall. And this pressure maintains the stability and firmness of the cell, and hence it also prevents the cell from plasmolysis. And because of this hydrostatic pressure, it also has a role in maintaining the turgidity of the cell. It keeps the cell firm. So it supports the plant parts like petals of the flower, leaves and young delicate stem. So you can see this is a turgid cell where the vacuole is quite bigger, which stores water and it maintains its shape. While in case of plasmolyzed cell where the water has come out of the cell, the vacuole is reduced. It has lost all its fluid and the plasma membrane has lost contact with the cell wall. It is separated from the cell wall. So this is a plasmolyzed cell, and vacuole has a really important role in any plant cell. It also has a major role in autophagy. Autophagy means when it engulfs and digests its own cell components. So, but this is not a negative feature of it. It actually maintains a balance between the production and degradation of various substances formed in the cell. So vacuole has a role in it. And it assists in the waste management process for the cell. So the waste generated in the cell is stored in a vacuole, and then the vacuole only expels it out through exocytosis. Also, it isolates, because it undergoes this waste management process, it also isolates the harmful material by removing it from the cytoplasm and storing it in the vacuole for a while. And another function is that turgor pressure which pushes the cellular components towards the cell wall. So the chloroplast present in the cell cytoplasm is also pushed towards the cellular membrane, which keeps the chloroplast closer to the light. So it becomes closer to the surface of the cell, and then it can trap more of light, and then that will increase the efficiency of photosynthesis process. And it is also a storehouse, a storage house, and it stores various molecules like amino acids, sugars, various organic acids, some proteins also, which can have the commercial importance also. So all these are the functions of vacuole. Now, for rest of the organelles, you can visit the link for part 5 and 6 of Fundamental Unit of Life. The link for both are given in the description box below.